Can you see him anywhere?
Must be one of the Dragoon's pets.
Over here, Clive! Are you all right?
Goats, there you are.
I didn't know there'd be a dragon.
All right. Let's get out of here.
Oh!
What now?
Is that Mother Crystal's heart?
What the hell is it doing up there?
Do this.
We must leave. Now, Your Grace, I beg of you.
This is not what he wanted. Something's happened. Forgive me, Yoda, but I must put a stop to this.
Your Grace!
So, what do we do now, then?
We destroy the heart.
But we might come back!
As soon as the flames die down, the Imperials and the Dalmechs will move in. This may be our only chance.
And Bahamut has gone for now. You should get as far away as you can, Goots.
What? And leave you slot in the ledge? I can't do that. If you're staying, then so am I. I packed everything up before I made a run for it, so if there's out you need, just ask. But I won't be giving it away for free. Nan would never forgive us if I did.
Thank you, Goot.
Do you need out? Welcome to Goots's Toll. Thank you. Is there out else you need? All done then. Anything else I can make for you? Whatever you need, leave it to me.
do it right.
I hope you like it. Good luck, Clyde.
Be brave now, boy.
Drake's tail is right there, Clive. It's time to free Storm from the crystal's curse.
I might need a moment.
Of course. Drake's tail.
Oh, but remember.
And I dare. No more roads.
We'll have to find our own path.
Do you feel that, Clive?
Ether. Just what we need. Another flood.
It's already turned them.
Then there's no reason to hold back.
Must be a way to climb up.
Thank you. Is that Phoenix?
Joshua!
What is he doing?
Keeping the Harmon occupied.
Joshua! Joshua!
Don't, Clyde. It's too dangerous.
Fuck. Hold on, Joshua. I'm coming! We have to save him.
And we will. We just need to keep moving.
Them again. Not now. Joshua! I'm here, brother!
Clive, he can't hear you.
Joshua!
They're heading for the heart.
And so should we.
Those the council chambers. How are they still standing?
I don't know.
He'll be all right, Clive. He's a survivor.
We're getting close. Like somebody doesn't want us getting any closer.
I don't care what it wants.
Neither do I.
These beasts, they're getting stronger.
We can think about them later.
Right now, there's only one thing we need to focus on.
The heart.
we might be able to get up through the building.
It's worth a try.
Quiet. There's someone up there.
Is someone there?
Mother.
It's you.
What happened here?
He tried to take him from me. Oh, my boy. My darling. Darling boy.
Is this the child you made with the Emperor? Why, Mother? Why did you betray us all?
You have no right!
Answer him.
We took you in, savage. Show some respect for those who raised you. Honorable Elwyn, always thinking of his precious homeland. But what worth is a homeland in a world beset by the Blight?
Father did not seek to protect his country. He sought to protect his people.
A leader's duty is not to protect his people. It is to protect the source of his sovereignty. The noble blood that runs in his family's veins. So long as this bloodline remains unbroken, what does it matter if a nation falls? One can always found another. Unlike him, I did my duty. I preserved my line. I bore a son of the noblest blood to whom the whole world might kneel. That is why I gave Rosaria to Sambrek. That I might join my line with the Lesages and birth a savior of this benighted land, blessed by both Bahamut and the Phoenix!
You sold your country for a child.
Why did he need another? You had Joshua.
I had nothing. You were always your father's son, so very strong and bold and daring, and yet you failed to awaken. Would that Joshua had been granted a tenth of your strength. Oh! How the nobles laughed that Elwyn's firstborn was surely the son of a concubine, and my own, not long for this world. The shame of it! The shame of being slandered by one's inferiors! How could you ever know how that feels? It should have been you! Why didn't the Phoenix choose you?
She was every waking moment was spent trying to shoulder the burden that you and the Phoenix and the Duchy foisted on him. That's why I became his shield! To help bear the weight! But what did you do? You betrayed your own blood and surrendered your son to his fate!
Joshua, my darling boy. I never meant to hurt him. The soldiers' orders were clear. He was to be spared. Why did you survive when the only one I truly cared for died?
Have you not looked out of the window? Joshua is here! The Phoenix lives on! He's battling Bahamut as we speak! Joshua! Wake up! I am a shield of Rosaria. And I will do my duty.
What are you...
Joshua!
Clive! the Founder.
What now?
This is drinking me.
We have to stop him.
Oh.
stronger than this. Come on, Ifrit. Show us your true power.
Joshua.
Clive!
My brother.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
You're alive. We both are. Nothing else matters. I never dared hope that I would see this day.
Reunited at last.
Jill.
It is done. The demon that would tear our house apart is no more. Father.
The Mother Crystal. It's collapsing.
Right.
We need to leave.
No. Wait. I owe him a debt.
Fine.
Can nothing be done to call them off?
I regret not, Your Radiance. The Dragoons answer to none but His Imperial Highness. The Council is powerless to intervene.
We're hearing reports of rebel
madness is this, Theon. Focus all efforts on extinguishing the fires around the capital. The city can wait.
Turn, Italian man, go!
Your Radiance.
And I want you to find out
about the Dalmec's
movements.
By the light! Dion, have you taken leave of your senses? Call off the Dragoons at once!
Fear not. The populace will come to no harm at their hands. I am here to save you, Father.
Save me?
A creeping darkness hides in the heart of Sanbrec. It stems from your wife, the traitorous Annabella.
Not another word, Dion.
Father, though you may not see it, the darkness has taken hold of you. It has made you forget yourself. But I bid you remember, there was a time when you ruled not with cruelty, but with compassion. Why now do you turn your back on your people? Why now do you seek to stoke the fires of war? You too have borne witness to this change, Your Eminences. And you know, as well as I, who is responsible for it. A puppet now sits upon the throne. But cut his strings, and the master loses her power!
What?
Dion, you bear steel before your emperor?
Guards! Take him!
For every citizen who falls, another can be bred. For every home that burns, another can be built. Those were your words. But when the last of your citizens has fallen, and all of their homes have been reduced to ash, what will become of your empire, of its rulers, of your god? As the mother crystals crumble one by one, and the blight sweeps in to claim all that we hold dear, our people look to their emperor for protection. Yet he labors not to secure their futures, but to seize what is left of the twins for himself. Even if it should come at the cost of everything his loyal citizens have labored to build!
Dion, you must understand.
A small price to pay, is it not? You've been blessed with great power, Dion. Enough to win me the world. So go, claim Valestia for me, brother.
Dion.
Father, how he doted on his children. That he would die to protect me was plain. It was but a matter of when.
You planned this?
You did well to endure so long. But you broke in the end, as I knew you would. And now Muthos approaches. Put him to the proof. I would see if he breaks. Go, Bahamut. Kinslayer.
Story.
You cannot stay here, Mother. Come. Take my hand. Mother.
If it is consciousness that weaves your wills together, consciousness that blurs the boundary between your own will and that of others, then we shall set you apart once more. The ties that bind you shall be severed. And humanity returned to its proper place. By primogenesis shall a new age of reason begin.
Relax, Your Majesty. Don't you want to play? It's been a long time.
Yeah.
to Zero Wish.
Men, you are as meek as all the others.
Such feeble creatures. Gifted the power of icons, yet slaves to fickle emotions which usher you to your doom. And so you bind your fragile wills with strands of consciousness.
The wretched handiwork of a wretched people.
The Sons of Fire were united at last, and for but a moment, their flame burned bright. Soon, Muthos shall become our perfect vessel.
And then shall the world be remade.
Not before the bonds are severed, of trust, of respect, of love. Only when every strand of consciousness is cut away, may Muthos return to our side. By primogenesis shall all be undone. Mankind shall be rid of his wretchedness, and Muthos of his will. But while he yet clings to it, he has the power to forge bonds anew. And so we bid you. Find Muthos, and sever everyone.
To destroy that which has no physical form, you ask the impossible.
There is nothing your black blade cannot cut, Odin. We shall unite with Muthos. And bring forth a new world. So long as our vessel remains unclaimed by humanity.
It shall be done, Master. My will is yours.
How is your brother?
Asleep since I returned from the Dominion. Tyr says he should be back on his feet soon enough. For a while, at least. She discovered something on his chest. A swelling, circled in stone.
The curse. For every mountain we climb, another rises up to greet us, doesn't it?
It's never ending. Even the sky seems to have grown tired of it all. If I disturbed you. While he rests, I might as well see what Otto has to say.
To what do I owe the honor? So, will it be? It'd last you a good while.
Aye, it's a dangerous world out there. Better I'll be here. You're rubbing me blind, you know. You'll not find a better price than that. Is that all?
Did you see that? Tell me you saw that.
What are you making them skies then?
Clive! Quick look! Seen enough?
Oh, I wasn't expecting you back. Best of luck out there, Sid.
Otto, how fares the realm?
The realm? Oh, she's just fine. As long as you look past the fat storms at Mother Crystals and her skies are a roiling cesspit.
And Gav?
He's with your uncle in the Free Cities, helping Mid with her project. Sent an owl their way the moment the winds turn foul.
Do you have any good news?
Well, that depends on your definition of good.
All right, fine. What do you suggest we do?
Oh, no, I'm just the messenger. Olive, this could be that Lady Vivian and old Tomes have Vera. Could be that they don't.
I suppose not.
How is it that every one of your little excursions presages some inexplicable catastrophe? Not that you are to blame for the Dominion's fate. No one could have predicted the actions of the Crown Prince.
I'm sorry I couldn't save your home.
My countrymen are stronger than you think. A few toppled clock towers won't break their spirits.
I hope so.
Look at us. Tempting though it may be, sulking will not help us find a solution to this mess.
You believe there's one to be found?
I don't know. But I am certain we're more likely to find it if we first examine the facts. Beneath these darkened skies, fear and confusion reign over Valisthea. Oh, the lands around the fallen Mother Crystals had already begun to wilt for want of ether. But not like this. Crystals that filled wells and fueled furnaces, now nothing but pretty shards of rock. And those that hang from the people's necks cast nary a glimmer of light to keep the dark at bay. It is only a matter of time before the common folk convince themselves that the end of days is upon us. Yet I fear a swift end is more than we can hope for. While most of the world thirsts for ether, the remainder drowns in it, spawning Akashic in droves. And amidst the hordes of mindless beasts, with magics as like to fail as function, even the strongest nation would falter. Rosaria and the Iron Kingdom teeter on the brink of collapse, while the tragedy in Twinside has all but paralyzed the Holy Empire. Dalmechia fares little better. Rumor has it the ministers fled the capital after the fall of Drake's Fang, leaving their beloved republic to crumble. Walud, meanwhile, moves in earnest. The Einherjar has been sighted off Storm. The world, in short, is in chaos. It would seem our civilization was nothing but a castle of sand, to be washed away at the whim of the waves.
A castle of sand.
Not my best flourish, but it seemed fitting. The reports I've received are considerably more blunt in their appraisal. Without the protection of their nations, it will fall to the people to defend themselves against those who would take what is theirs.
Which is only ever going to end one way.
Defending a farmhouse against a band of chocobo thieves is one thing. But pitchforks and palisades will do little to stall an army's advance. Should the King of Walu deign to invade, there would be none to stop him.
None but us.
Guess. You're here about the skies.
Is there anything you don't know, Lawsman?
It doesn't take a court astrologer to augur the obvious. As for what has disturbed the heavens, that, I believe, is a question the Fallen might be better placed. And on the sixth day, but I dare say you remember your childhood lessons on the sins of Zemeckis only...
You think they're connected? That Ultima was one of the gods responsible?
Well... he has certainly exhibited powers that we mortals would associate with the divine.
There is nothing divine about him.
But he wouldn't be the first god of whom that could be said, now would he? Yet for all the fairy tales that tell of the sins, there is almost nothing in the way of actual historical accounts. Had I the Journal of Moth the Chronicler, I may have been able to tell you more, but you will forgive me.
Certainly not. Even without this journal, you've provided us ample wisdom. And we will always be grateful for it. Perhaps Otto will be more inclined to share his thoughts when he hears what the others had to say.
Good morrow to you, my friend. I don't believe you've read this particular chapter before. A rather fascinating excerpt I've been meaning to show you. If you have a question for me, I should be happy to answer it. Always welcome, Clive.
How may I help you today? Thus ends today's lesson.
Clive, we have a problem.
Only one. That would be a first.
It would. Actually, there are three. We had as many owls arrive while you were at the shelves. Martha's got a Kashyyyk out her gates, and talk of monsters roaming the hills outside of Northreach has put the wind up Isabel and her lot.
And don't forget Dalimil. Lubor says the village was raided by bandits.
When it rains,
it fucking pours. The Cursebreakers are spread thin, taking stock of the damage in the Dominion. And even if I could get word to all of them, I doubt they'd get here in time to make any... Which means... There's only two, but
Jill and I.
Let them know we're on our...
See the pair that got hauled into tires.
This man's gonna die if we don't get him to a healer.
Martha.
And you, Clive.
Otto said he'd been attacked by a Kashyyyk.
Those skies are what happened. Not long after they... There were hundreds of them. Tried to storm the hill. Only a handful made it up. The rest are still down there now. And while we have a few willing... What do you think, Clive?
That we join.
I thought you'd know. Now, where I need you is the Fallen. Let the men know you've come to help.
We're on our way.
Do you think there are as many as Martha says?
More.
You don't think they've abandoned us, do you?
Clive, wounded.
We deal with the Akashic first.
Let there be light!
These men don't have the look of hired swords.
If you've come to rob this place...
You are mistaken, my Lord Rosfield. We're here by Madame Martha's li-
How do you know my
Forgive me, my lord. There wasn't time for
Wade's men? Where is your commander?
Sir Wade left earlier with a scouting party.
Did he? Take your wounded back to the- Martha will see you're looked up.
And to think you took them for thieves. A fine reward for holding off the horde, that.
When did Wade and his men arrive?
Not long after Rosalith fell. The Guardians asked me to shelter. They were making ready to leave, just...
Martha! Trouble! The scouting party's almost at the lift. But they got a pack of... And they got wounded with them!
Damn it all.
We'll worry about them.
You look after everyone here. If any can still fight, send them to the lift. I will. You...
My brothers.
How do you? Fare thee well. My dogs.
Squire, I need you to get those who can still walk up the lift to-
But what about-
I didn't ask, Oscar.
Sir.
Sir Wade.
Lord Rosfield. If-
Martha seemed to think you might- And by the looks of it-
We thought we could sneak, but we didn't know there would be so many.
Behind you!
We need to get the injured to safety.
Do you think we can hold them off?
We can certainly try. Are you with us, Sir Wade?
Always.
Then let's do our duty. Now, Torgo!
Is anyone hurt?
I don't think so.
And yet again, you've pulled me from the flames. It's just a pity I keep walking into them.
You've never been one to shy away from danger, Sir Wade. Like any shield worthy of the name.
I see you're all in one piece.
Martha!
Is something wrong?
The lookout saw smoke coming from down East Poolway. Too thick to be a hearth.
A second horde.
Feel like finishing the job?
Always.
Jill and I will make for East Pool. You'll need to move the injured without us.
Don't you worry about them.
The moment my men are safe, I'll follow. Good luck.
This man's gonna die if we don't get him to a healer.
Just patch me up as quick as you
headed for the rest.
We have to slow them down. Martha and the others won't be ready.
Something's coming.
Apologies, my lord. Did I miss anything?
Only the first round, Sir Wade. Shall we? Do you see any more?
No. I think that was the last of them.
But it won't be long before the next lot arrive.
Then we make for Martha's while we can.
What did you find out there?
The same as Sir Wade. Scores of Akashic.
Well, we're at hopefully how many of oh, damn.
It was a it's not a map. The inn.
What?
My lord, there's someone I'd like you to meet. Oscar, over here. It is an honor to make your acquaintance, Lord Rossfield. I am Oscar. Oscar of House Murdoch.
Murdoch? I wasn't aware the Lord Commander had children.
Oh, he didn't. But his brother... My father did. I am Sir Rodney's nephew.
Well, go on, then. It's not for me to ask him.
Yes, Sir Wade. If it please you, my Lord Marquis, might you take me as your squire? I would learn the duties of a shield from the finest.
I'm sorry to disappoint you, Oscar, but I'm a shield no longer, nor was I ever the finest. And spending time in the company of an outlaw hardly seems a fitting education for one aspiring to take his oaths.
My Aunt Hannah once told me that a man is not defined by his title, but what he does in its name. You have accomplished much since taking on the mantle of Cid, winning no little honor in so doing. And I would sooner serve under an honorable outlaw than an unworthy shield. Not that Sir Wade and the other guardians are... I mean to say that,
It's all right. We know what you mean. There is only so much the boy can learn from me, my lord.
But a squire...
Would that really be so bad? You were a squire once. And I'm certain Sir Rodney would approve.
Know that I'll show you as much leniency as your uncle showed me.
I would not have it any other way!
You are right, boy. First, we find Isabel.
Heard a bloke saying he saw ghosts on the far side of the room.
I saw it with my own eyes.
We received the dame's message. There have been sightings of strange creatures, I understand.
With the blue eyes. Yes. Like Akashic, but... different. They've taken so many. I've lost count.
Akashic, but different.
Ultimus Thrall. And what of your mistress? Is she here?
Oh, no. She went to the garrison to ask what they were planning on doing about all this.
Then we'll look for her there.
Four left for more on the captain's orders.
Half the garrison's been slaughtered by those things. We lost the captain this very morning.
We've tried requesting reinforcements, but there's been no word from the capital or the Dominion in days!
What more would you have us do?
I would have you do your duty. Those at the Vale look to me for protection. And protect them I shall. Because they are my charges, and that is my duty. In case you have forgotten, the people of this town are your charges. But more than that, they are your people. Your sisters, your brothers, your lovers. So you have a choice. Lay down your sword and watch as they are slaughtered, or take it up and do what is right.
She speaks the truth, you know. This here, it's all we have. It's all that's left.
What we have left is our lives! Do you really want us to-
Not if we don't. My level.
Oh, Clive. I didn't expect help to arrive so quickly. And sought to take matters into my own hands.
It was a noble effort. But I thought you might still need some support.
I'd like you to consider my needs.
What we need to consider is where the creatures came from.
The way the survivors speak of them, one would think they appeared out of thin air. And perhaps they did. It's hard to know what to believe these days.
Don't leave me, Paul.
You're a pikeman, yeah?
I've got a family and a pack of...
Leave.
That thing.
Did you see the creature?
They came out.
Do you remember where?
On the rope.
It's all right. At least we have an idea of where the thralls might be now. We should head for more.
I assume you have a plan.
We need to find out what we're doing.
Was all they could. Do to escape.
Let's go.